Hi, I'm Jena Taylor, and I'm the director here at Faith City Mission. And we're celebrating our 65th year right now, this year, and all the things that have happened from the day this mission opened to today. And I want to tell you a little bit about those things. 65 years ago, Bee Hogan, darling little lady, love God with all her heart, felt like the Lord had told her there was supposed to start a homeless shelter here in Amarillo. That would have been in 1951. And so she went to her husband and said, honey, I believe that the Lord has told me that we're supposed to start a homeless shelter here in Amarillo. And the husband said, you have lost your mind. We're not going to start a homeless shelter. We're just church people, and we're not going to do that. And Bee was very, very wise, because she said, you know what? I know you love God, and I know you hear His voice, and I know God loves you, and I know that He speaks to you, so I'm going to let Him deal with you. And so she left it at that, wise woman. And a week later, Dick Hogan came back to his wife and said, oh, all right, we'll start a homeless shelter. And so they started a storefront shelter. I think it was on Polk, I'm not sure, but it was in 1951. And we have pictures of the little white iron beds and the wooden folding chairs. And it was probably, I don't know, it appeared to be about 20 beds. And it was actually at that time, even at that time, also a recovery program. Of course, it was faith-based. So they began to feed meals, and then they began to house these guests. And this whole thing started in this tiny storefront. And now you can see that we have moved to another building, and we have refurbished this building and made rooms. And as you see right now, we're in the art studio. And in this, it's actually a class that we teach to our recovering personnel. And that is because art is a creative process by which the students can raise their endorphin levels. Because creating something with one's hands raises endorphin levels, we take this class very seriously. This is a serious class. It's not for just for fun, although that's okay too. One of the things that students have to learn is how normal people have fun. And so that's important too. So this is something we've added to the curriculum. We have therapists here now, and they also help the students recover, as well as giving them amino acids that kind of lowers their anxiety level. In other words, one of the amino acids they take here is L-tryptophan, which is found in turkeys, which of course makes us all go to sleep on Thanksgiving afternoon after we've had our turkey. It's just a calming effect. Another thing that we do here is chiropractic appointments for our students, because this helps them in their recovery. Dr. Shane Hand, chiropractor, also our board president, he actually comes and volunteers his time once a week to bring staff and students an ability to go ahead and be adjusted. And I think one of the things I'd like to share with you right now in this 65th year is some statistics. Some guys and women love statistics. So I'll tell you this, that last year we had served 83,000 meals. That's a lot of food, and yet that's what we served last year. Now also, because that's part of what we do is feed, but we also preach the gospel. We're faith-based, and so we had, last year, we had almost 600 salvations. What's interesting to me is that this year, here we are in September, we're already at 500 salvations. So I feel like the Lord's come and, you know, really blessed the work here. So those are kind of fun statistics. Anyway, there's so much more to share, and I'll begin sharing more of that with you, but we just want you to celebrate our 65th year with us and enjoy the things that God's doing here at the Mission.